Hello, people of the internet. I'm back off of my holiday and I am fancying doing some colouring, and I fancy doing one of these, which are, I've been watching a lady the last couple of nights to fall asleep to, and that sounds horrible, but I watch colouring people and I drift off in a little dream world. I've been watching Danny Buttons, and I've gone back through some of her back catalogue where she shows her colouring pages, all her colouring book collection and the pages she's done in them. And I love her relaxed attitude to using felt tip pens and not worrying about the streaks. And she does some really nice Disney colour by number French books, which are single, double-sided, so you have to use felt tip pens. And just watching her made me want to use or have a go of fibre tip pens, felt tip pens as we call them. And this book, clearly, you have to use fine liners with, or you know, the fine end of a felt tip pen. I'm just trying to see, are they all the colours that you have to pick? Look how small the spaces are. I just really fancy doing it. There's orange and yellow. There's an orange and yellow there. There's a blue and a lighter blue. Yeah, so maybe that's how we match up the colours. Now, I think the pens I'm going to use, I was going to use the Staedtler fine liners. But I might use, okay, this is my, send you up into the sky a little bit so we can see more. This pencil case, my husband bought me this one for Christmas, and in it I have all my, I call them fine liners, but they're sort of all the fine fibre tip pens that have a fine line end. Oh, that one's around the wrong way. Can't be doing with ones around the wrong way. So these are the Arteza dual, what are they called? They're not twee markers. So that's all 100 of those. Actually, it's not. It's 99 of those, because my pack of twee markers came with two of the same colour. This one here. No, must be this one here. No, must be this one here. Yes, apple green and apple green. Instead of having 100 colours, I got 99 colours and a spare apple green. So I got the Arteza twee markers. Then I have a packet set of Stabilos 88s, 1988. What are they called? They are called 88. Yeah, 0.88. And everyone always says that these don't have colour numbers on them, but they do, people. They do, people of the internet. Look, this yellow is number 88/44. And then the orange is 88/54. That's their colour numbers. I know! And then red is 50, and pink is 56, and purple is 58. So if you always thought your Stabilos 0.88 fine liners didn't have colour numbers, they do. And then I was going to say, at the back are my fine liners. Who's that company? Staedtler fine liners, the ultimate fine liners, the fine liners everyone. But I took them out and put them in a pencil case to take on holiday with me. So now I've got to go and get that pencil case. Probably be a good time to put them back away as well. I snuck these in after I did my packing video. So all you people were looking going, oh, what's your packing video? You didn't take no fine liners. Well, I snuck these in afterwards. And the reason why I snuck this pencil case in afterwards was because I wanted to take three light flesh tone Tombow markers. Because when I do my Fairies in Dreamland book, I do everything with glitter pens apart from the fairies. It's like in fairyland, everything is made of glitter apart from the fairies. So I wanted to take three of those. And there are sometimes when I'm doing the fine decals in Fairyland book, I use my these. Now, I was going to say, oh, I'll sit here and put them back in here in colour order. But you really don't want to watch me do that, do you? But this is where they belong. Oh, these are just flat gel pens, non-glitter gel pens. I use them up sometimes doing mandalas. So let me just whip through and put these back in here in colour order, because I have to have everything in order before I start. Even though I'm not 100% sure that I'm going to use these. Now these, strangely enough, everyone says that these don't have colour names and numbers. They do, but when you buy them in a pack, they don't have the numbers on them. But if you buy them individually, they do have the colour numbers and names on them. And I know that because I used to specifically buy, and I have one in the drawer here, this colour, and I used to order it off of Cult Pens directly, and it's number 334-34. I think it used to be called turquoise blue. Do I even have one in here? Are they the same? Yeah, they're the same. Because I used to use that for when I sell stuff on eBay. ArtJourney's sort of colour is tealy blue, and so I used to use that to write a thank you note. So I used to order that separately, so I knew what colour it was. Right, what comes after orange? Would you say this one's orange, or is this one brown? We'll stick it here with the oranges because it looks orangey. We'll call it dark orange. Red, dark red. I never do rainbow order. I do, well, it's sort of rainbow order if you went this way, red, orange, yellow. I start with the lightest colour and then fade down. So we've got pink. There's a really, I always go into light pink. Dark, up. Red fading into pink. And then pink into light purple. All that done. So let's pretend that they were in there. So this is my art scissors. This is my 0.88. I keep saying Stabilos for these, but these are not. Oh yeah, they are Stabilo. And these are Stadlers. Now I'm not sure which ones I'm going to use. So I need a piece of paper. Piece of paper. And I need to determine which ones I baseball cap on so my head's not quite in your face. Let us zoom right in. Let's just angle you a little bit. There we go. And that's a Stabilo. Stadlers. Oh, I've also got some Bics in here as well. I don't think I've got enough colours in the 0.88s, and I really don't like them. They're really fine and scratchy. And then I've got the Artesas. Now that's the fat side, the brush side. They're quite nice actually. And then that's, oh, they feel even thinner than Stabilos. But then I've got the option, if it's a big space, I can use the other one. All right, let's match up the Artesas and see how it goes. See how it goes. All right. Zoom in a little bit. Now, sorry. All right. Start by gathering all the colours used on the colouring page. So does it mean So this one's all browns. There's three different browns. Is there three different browns in there? No, there's only two different browns. Aye. Do I just start at the beginning? We're looking for this beigey colour. Let's do this. Beigey colour. Oh, this is going to be more difficult than I think, isn't it? And I'm doing it on camera for the first time. What colour? Have I swatched it? I have swatched these, haven't I? Have I? Yes. Of course I have. Of course I have, people of the internet. Ooh, zooming you out, not in. Because we all know the power of the swatch. So, which? That's Tombow's. That's either before or after them. Oh, Caesars. Camel brown looks like the lightest brown then. Or biscotti brown. That is a real fleshy brown though, isn't it? What is this picture? Original painting number 55. Oh, the original paintings are at the back, by the way. Oh, it's that one. It's supposed to be like a cloudy sky. Oh, I don't think I want to do that one first. I want to do a nice one. Oh, that looks quite nice. A lot of blue in that one. I want to do one that I do, because I really like that irises one. I've seen that in real life in the art gallery and it's beautiful. So I don't want to do that one first because I mess up. Which is likely I will. Okay, we're just going. That's a small one. Maybe I'll do that one. Number 21, page 51. Wheat filled with crows. Number 21 is smaller, so that's probably a good thing. Right, let's do this one. Squish the book down. Get me a drink. Apple juice with water. And spill it. Right. Well, that's the book ready to go. Right, now I've got a match up. Oh, this doesn't look too bad. It hasn't got that. Hasn't got the really light beige on it, but it's got, how many yellows has it got there? Are they the same? It's two. That's definitely a light yellow, and that's definitely an orange yellow. So we're looking for a really light yellow to start off with. The lightest yellow in the Arteezers. What have I got in Tombow's? Have I got enough to do this in Tombow's? Let's do the first one with Arteezers, and then I see how bad it comes out. Right, that is a really light creamy green. Let's go for it. Let's use sapphire yellow as the creamy green. Creamy yellow, I mean, because it is the lightest yellow. Right, let me swatch book there. Get my sapphire yellow, which is the lightest one. Take my glasses off, so now I have no idea what you can see on the camera. Right, move my pencil case over. And, oh my word, these are so small. These are so small. Oh, it matches quite nicely, you know. I'm supposed to colour in chat, aren't I? I'm no good at colouring chat. Oh, you can't even see. Sorry. If I can move you, if I move you like that, I can have it a little bit nearer to my old blind eyes. That's it. Have I done there? Yeah. Okay, there's two more bits over here. These are quite nice to do this with. I did always wonder what I was going to use the Arteza. Tree markers for, but I may have found their calling because they do cover up that dot quite nicely. Where is some more? There's a horse. Hunt the dot. Oh dear, I'm so blind. You're probably, because you're so zoomed in, you're actually closer to it than me. I'll do my glasses because I'd be better with my glasses on. No, because I have supersonic vision close up. I'm short-sighted, I see brilliantly close up, but terribly at a distance. And when I put my glasses on, I can't see distance, middle distance very well. Now before you say, oh, you should get bifocals. They made me bifocals, but I have to have, how attractive is this? I have to have a prism in my glasses because I've got a bit of a lazy eye. And you can't have bifocals if you have a prism. Because the prism takes up... Right, if this, the prism takes up this part of the glasses, so you can't have dual lens. Where's the rest of... There's another light one there. Right, where does that spread to? Because that's part of it. I bring you in again, sorry. That's part of it. That's part of it. The only good thing as well about using brush tip markers. Oh, you're a bit blurry, sorry. I can't see because the camera. Good thing about using brush tip markers is you feel like you're painting. So I could pretend to be Van Gogh, Van Gogh. Should really put some music to this. I might do at this point because my little brain is going to switch off and relax. Actually, I was tagged. I've been tagged by two different tag videos that I've got to do. One of them, I need to go and watch what the tag is. It is why you enjoy colouring. Five reasons I enjoy colouring or something like that. I need to go and watch the actual original tag. And what other people, you know, what you're supposed to do and say. But I can tell you something for nothing. If this is not the tag video, it should be. Because the reasons I enjoy colouring are... I love pens. I've always loved pens and stationery. And I can't draw. I haven't got an artistic bone in my body. And I started art journaling because it was something that I could do. Didn't have to be massively artistic, but I still wasn't very good at that. And then I discovered colouring, or rediscovered colouring. I used to do it secretly, like a dirty little secret habit that I'd colour in, because it was only kids' book. You had to buy kids' colouring books. And then adult colouring came out, and the first adult colouring book that I saw in 2015 was Joanna Bashford's Secret Garden, and I was like, I can come out of the closet, I can colour as an adult. And so I started colouring, and I just loved using my pencils and my pens and everything that I owned. Finally they had a use of all these. I sort of collected more than used, because I love stationery, always have done. I used to love back to school time and going there. I used to save up my pocket money all of the 6 weeks holiday, and then I'd spend a whole day walking around Woolworths and WH Smith's and picking the things that I'd be taking back to school. And it would be like, oh, I'm going to get that set of erasers, and I'm going to get that set of pens and I'm gonna get that pencil case, and then I'd go and have a look in WH Smith and make sure there was something, not anything better. And even as an adult, back to school time in August, September, when all the stationery goes in the stores, I was like, yeah. And so I've always been a sort of collector of beautiful pens, and I've even got fountain pens. I did a whole, I used to make videos about fountain pens. I think most of them are not online anymore. Yeah, suddenly colouring was allowed as an adult. So I, you know, bought some colouring books, and then unfortunately I got really, really busy at work, and everything fun stopped. And I am really busy at work again now, but I don't know what happened. I'm trying to remember, really. I think it was just like October last year. I wasn't at the school anymore because I'd gone to, a tiny little bit there. We have a contract with a really big school, and the person who was the service delivery manager at the school, something happened which I can't talk about, and they needed someone in an emergency to go and cover for us down there. And so they said, will you go down there for a month? I said, yep, I'll give you May. And I went down there, and it was, needed a lot of work to turn the team around, and I ended up being there for 2.5 years. And when you work at a school, especially the type of school that this was, you're not advised, to have a social media presence, because if any of the kids find your social media presence, then yeah. So I had to take down all the videos that had my face on it and all that kind of stuff, so I just took everything down. And then that was a really, really busy time. And so after that, once that came to an end, which was in December, how long have I been off the school now? December 2019, that was it. I got back to the office January, and then a couple of months later, COVID, bish bash bosh. That's it, no longer in the office. But yeah, I think it was really October 2020. I hadn't, you know, during lockdown I'd been working from home and working, you know, normal hours. I didn't have a lot of downtime, but things started to tail off a little bit in October, and I was looking on Amazon, and I just bought myself a set of the Arteza water brush pens. They was on a really cheap deal, and I thought, I fancy them, I'm buying them. So I bought them, they came, I didn't like them, but I started buying art materials again, and that was it really. Here I am, colouring again, and really enjoying the hobby at the moment, though I might have to turn the big light on. Looks really nice and light for you here, but it's kind of overcast. Talking of overcast, we had an amazing weather for our holiday. It was like, we're back to sort of normal weather now, 16 degrees and a bit grizzly. While we was on holiday, it was 30 degrees. It felt like we was in Greece. We had the most amazing, my husband's got an amazing tan, I've got an amazing tan, we was on the beach. This is easier than I thought, you know. It's also more enjoyable than I thought. When I first saw it, I thought it was going to be a bit too small and a bit difficult to cover up the dots. But neither of those things are true. And like I say, using this brush tip just makes me feel like I'm painting. Right, is that it? Oh, one more there. Now, if I turn the big light on, the big light, you know what I mean, the overhead light, you're going to get the shadow of the camera. But needs must, otherwise I won't see what's occurring. Is that it? Might be. Oh, one more there. You know, Van Gogh, all those years ago, thought there'd be some woman in East London colouring in dots that represent his picture. Nope, he would not. And not only colouring dots that represent his picture, but making a video of it for the internet. Didn't even know what a video was. Right, let me go and turn the big light on. Yeah, there is going to be a shadow now. Sorry, that's the shadow of my hair. Right, what is this? There is a more orangey colour. Let's have a look. Not quite that orange, maybe that one. Maybe lemon yellow. Oh, I think lemon yellow will be it. Oops, sorry. Flicked the camera. This one, lemon yellow. Let's try a small one just in case it's wrong. No, that's too light. It needs to be more orangey than that. It doesn't cover up the dot. So let's try cantaloupe orange 229. That looks alright. Paper's torn up a little tiny bit there. Where I went over it in two different colours. Move the pens back again. And we're doing this light one. But that is, feels like it should be more yellow. But the yellow, wasn't, that first one matched so well that this one feels that it doesn't match quite as well. Oh, and there's lots of it as well. Sorry. What was I saying? I was saying that we had really nice weather on holiday and we were really lucky. And the last day we were there, it was supposed to be, well, showing on the weather, that it was going to be raining and thunderstorms. And then at the last minute it changed to be a nice hot sunny day before the storms came that night. So the last day was beautiful.
We went into the next sort of town and went and had lunch and had a really nice time actually. And obviously then we went to bed. It rained in the night, we woke up in the morning, it was raining. And we drove through the rain to get home, which was lovely because it was like, haha, we've had the very best weather that we could have and we're leaving when it's raining. And the people who came after us so far, they've been there 3 nights, or 3 days, 2 nights, and they've had rain the whole time. I don't mean that horribly, but we were just exceptionally lucky with the weather. Got to concentrate, otherwise I just... Isn't it funny, right? You see these tiny little books and you think to yourself, oh my god, I'm never going to do that. Oh my god. And then when you start, it just goes... It's quite easy. It's quite straightforward. It's Just wiggling the pen around on a bit of paper. And when you watch other people do it, they go over the lines and you think, oh, they've gone over the lines. But it doesn't, you know, it doesn't really matter. Right, that's the same, that's the same, that's the same, that's the same. We've got a big load here the same. These are the perfect pens for this book. Because they're brush pens, they don't pour out loads of, I was going to say ink, it's not ink. They don't pour out loads of it. The water and pigment. So you have to sort of, you just flow in the pen across the page and not, you know, like if it's a felt pen, you go, it really wets the paper, doesn't it? Are these even going through? A little bit. Up there they were. That was the bit where I went over it with yellow and then re-went over it with the orange. They're not really, really, really wet in the paper. Plus you can do a really floaty, light hand. Not particularly streaky, are they? I can't even remember what this picture was. Does anyone remember what this picture was? Am I still recording? Yeah. I panicked then that somehow I turned it off. That first yellow matched the yellow dot so well, you cannot see the dot at all. This one, you can still see the dot a little bit. It's almost like the yellow needed to be a dark yellow, of which there isn't really one. Maybe pear green would have been better. I know that sounds funny, but in the Arteezers watch book, pear green looks like a dark yellow. Mm-mm, my tongue's out, concentrating. Didn't think I'd ever be any good at colour chats because I just zone out. But I really fancied having a go of this book with the dots. There's another one. It's quite a lot of this dark yellow. Oh, that's a big bit. I don't think it's matters too much that I'm using that orangey yellow, because it, I think this is all hay fieldy stuff, and the next colour next to it, oh, I went right over the line there. Did you see that? Just like, it's like there was no line. I just let it go. Let it go, let it go. You're wonderful wind and snow. Now this is probably a picture that's not up anyone else's street apart from me, but I like arty stuff. I'm just not very good at it. Bit is red, but that bit is orange. Does anyone remember what this picture was? There's another bit there, and 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 there. There's a lot of yellow in this. What I should do, probably just finish this yellowy bit. Right, hang on, let's have a look at the time. It's 10 to 5. There. Oh. All of this bit. All of this bit. If I did a bit wrong bit here, who is ever going to know? Who is ever going to look and go, you missed a bit there. You went over the line. That tiny little millimetre should have been dark orange, and you did it light orange. dark orange. See, I was there. If you're wondering how small these squares are, the answer is bloody small. The dots are about, I always say about, when I could get the tape measure out, that I've gone right over the line there.
Doesn't matter. Van Gogh didn't have lines, did he?
They're 2 millimeters.
No, that's inches. 2/8 of an inch.
Millimeter wise, they are. Oh no, they are 2 millimeters. What the?
Okay, I'm not good with inches.
They are 1/16 of an inch. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, they are 1/16 of an inch. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
That's how small the dots are. Did you even see me measuring it? Well, believe me, I did.
Once I finish this, it does not look like a Van Gogh picture.
I'll be so disappointed.
I just took a drink. Yeah, you can see the yellow dot a bit in this one. Can't go over too many times because the paper starts to rough up. This is like one shot. Okay, where is there more yellow? Yeah, 2 big blobs here. I think I will have another go of these in my Tombow markers. Not that there's anything wrong with these at the moment, but... Oh, you know what else I could have used?
I forgot them
Ohuhu water-based markers that I have. Right, let's finish with these. We can have a little... What works best in...
Colour by dots.
Monet, whatever, Van Gogh. Could have done it in gel pens. What would Van Gogh say? Oh, which bits are these? Yeah. Can you imagine? He'll probably cut off his other ear.
She did the ball pen then, and her gel pens. I am an artist. This oil painting. She did it with gel pens. Glittery gel pens.
No meaning to Starry Night, that would be, wouldn't it? Glittery, glittery night. Paint the world with glitter pens. La 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 la. Remember that song by Don McLean? Called Vincent, wasn't it? Starry, starry night, Stains of in blue and gold. Is that the words? I don't know. Oh, there's loads here, isn't it? I don't know the words. Stop singing. You don't know the words. I do know the words when it's playing. I just don't know the words off the top of my head. No. Stop singing. You don't know the words. You're just making it up. For that, I'm just letting it go now because there's two bits next to each other.
Looks dark on camera.
Looks more really orangey. He had a thing about orange, didn't he, Van Gogh? Or probably burnt umber.
Or umber.
Or yellow ochre. Or whatever, the only two paints that they could probably get back in 18, whatever. Maybe what I'll do is while you're watching this, I'll have some facts about Van Gogh coming up on the screen. Rather than
nothing.
You hearing me trying to sing. Mm-hmm. What happens if I use the other side? Oh no, they're too scratchy. To get the colour out, you've got to go over too many times. Oh god, there's so much of this yellow. He struggled for his fantasy.
I don't know the words. I want to look it up now.
Starry, starry night.
Ouch.
Paint your palette blue and grey. Look out on a summer's day. With eyes that know the darkness.
See my soul. Close down the hills, sketch the trees and daffodils, catch the breeze and the winter hills in colours on the snowy linen land. Now I understand. What should you try to say to me? How you suffered for your sanity. How you tried to set them free. They would not listen. They did not know how. Perhaps they'll listen. Starry, starry night. Flame.
Swirling clouds in violet haze reflect in Vincent's eyes of china blue, colors changing hue. Morning fields of amber grain, weathered faces lined in pain, are soothed beneath the artist's loving hand.
Now I understand. What you tried to do, how you struggled for your sanity,
how you tried to set them free,
they would not listen, they did not know how.
perhaps.
Perhaps
listen now.
For they could not love you, but still your love was true. And when no hope was left in sight on that starry, starry night, you took your life as lovers often do. But I could have told you,
this world was never meant for some.
Starry, starry night. Portraits hung in empty halls. Frameless heads on nameless walls. With eyes that watch the world and can't forget. Like the strangers that you've met, the ragged men in ragged clothes, the silver thorn of bloody rose, lie crushed and broken on the virgin snow. Now I think I know
what you tried to say to me. Now how you struggled
for your sanity, how you tried to set them free. They would not listen, they're not listening still.
Perhaps they never will.
They never will.
Well, it's lucky I'm not monetized, because I'm sure that playing that while I'm doing this would totally demonetize this video. But I'm not monetized, even though I have hundreds of thousands of hours of YouTube. They demonetized me because I didn't put up a video for 6 months. And I have to get back to having 4,000 hours, which is crazy. Yeah, even though I've had this channel for 10 years, more than 10 years, even though I have hundreds of thousands of views, I don't, am not monetized. It was nice hearing that though, wasn't it? I just get into the old Van Gogh mindset. You're probably, it
was nice listening to that.
You've probably all tuned out and gone, that's it. She's lost it. There's a lot of yellow. I mean, the strange thing is about these pictures when they're just dots, they're like mystery pictures. I've got my glasses on, I can see quite well actually. The mystery pictures. Oh, I just realised I'm looking over the top of my glasses, that's why I can see well. is most of the time when you start colouring, you can see what they are, like the Disney ones. You go, oh, it's a Mickey Mouse. This one is a mystery picture, and you can get all the way done and you still won't know what it is, because it's one of them sort of impression art things, really. I wish this colour covered the dots a bit better, like the first yellow did. This pen's getting really frayed. I don't even use it that much. Let's just hope there's not more Van Gogh pictures using this colour in this book, because this pen is very frayed. Is that it? Have I done it all? Have I done all that colour? I think I might have. There's some little bits where I've missed.
It's an impression.
It's impressionist art. Okay, I think it is. So the next one is a more deeper orange. Nothing. Alright, let's have a look. I don't want anything fluorescent. I want something. That one bright orange looks nice and dark. Or just orange. Or yellow ochre. Or let's try the yellow ochre first, because that's probably ancient colour, isn't it? 204. Where have I got 204? Yellow ochre. Right, is this one going to be this kind of colour? Or is that too light? I think it's too light. Sorry, Vincent. Not using your favourite yellow ochre. Need something a bit darker. Probably need... It's bright orange. Cadmium orange, earth red, marmalade orange, bright orange, peach orange. Bright orange doesn't look that bright on the swatch. So let's go for this. Try this. Nope, needs to be darker. Oh, where are we going to go now then? Earth the red? Maybe. I wish they had a swatchy bit at the back where you could see the dots. It doesn't. So, marmalade orange, orange, earth red, or papaya orange. Earth red or papaya orange. Let's try this earth red. Yep. Sorry, but that's the monkey. This one's more juicy, so it's leaving a little bit more soaking into the paper a bit more. Doesn't matter too much because it will just look like Van Gogh's brush strokes. He didn't care that we saw his brush strokes, did he? Starry, starry night. This is another one that's got a bit of a frayed nib. Also needs a double layer to cover the dot up. Stop singing. I'm one of them people that sing all the time. That is awful what's happened here. It's all sort of blending into each other. Not in a good way. Sort of just went soaked into the paper either side. I sing. People go, oh, you must be nice and relaxed singing away there. But I actually, my brain starts singing when I'm stressed. Like, here we go, I'm going to calm you down. So you just start singing the theme tune from the Muppet Show. Right now, while you're in this very stressed situation. And I'm like, what? Walking around, evaluating a system that's gone down. And going, it's time to start the music. It's time to light the lights. It's time to meet the Muppets on the Muppet Show tonight. Boom, boom, boom. I'm like, what? I bet this would look lovely in pencils, like proper shaded and everything. I bet all you lovely pencil artists are watching it going, oh, that would look lovely in pencils. Probably. I do like pencils, but I'm a one coat wonder. At the moment I am anyway. I like seeing all the beautiful, you know, things that people do with pencils, but at the moment, nearly spilt me drink. Might as well finish it actually. I might get frustrated though if this was pencils. The bits are really small. Have to have mega sharp pencils and I'd want to go one go, not shading. Right, are we going to think that this is going to look like the Van Gogh painting at the end? At the moment it's just, might as well be a mandala, mightn't it? I really want to do one of these in gel pens now, though. Oh, has it got Starry Night in this book? Imagine doing Starry Night all glitter pen. No, I don't think it has. No, but the iris one would look nice done. My tongue is out. By the way, I'm decluttering some of my colouring books at the moment. In fact, I've gone through all my colouring books and already uploaded a video. Which I shall link up there in the corner. but I'm still buying stuff. It's almost like I'm on this. Oops, no, I missed a bit there. Like I'm on this exploration of products and finding things that I like. And then while watching videos, thinking, oh, that looks good. And then when it turns out, thinking, nah, that's not for me. And so letting it go straight away because I know it's not for me. Some things I know that I will come back to, like Kirby Rosanis books. I know that one day I will do those because they're gorgeous. And it's like I've revisited some of the books. But I'll show you in another declutter part 3 video, which will go up after my, I've done a vlog from my holiday, and then I bought some stuff even while I was on holiday. How naughty was that? We went to the range. It was a huge range, massive it was. It's on two floors, never seen a range like it, and its crafts section was so big.
They had so much different stuff than our one. Our one doesn't really have anything.
And I was overwhelmed the first time I went there, and I bought something that I'd wanted, that I'd seen on the Range website, but they'd never had in our one, and I didn't think you could get any more. And I bought that, and then when we got back to the house we were renting, I said to my husband, oh, there was so many things there that I fancied. I feel like going back and having a spend up. Well, he was like, well, you should have got it while you were there. And I was like, yeah, I know, but at the moment I'm trying to, you know, not buy stuff. I spent a bit of time looking up the stuff on the internet to see whether you could get it elsewhere or cheaper, or people were selling their old ones on eBay or anything like that, really. And there wasn't. And then a couple of days later, we were going on that our last day, actually, when we were going into the other town, we went past this big Range again, and I said, oh, there's a big Range again. And my husband said, well, we'll stop on the way back. And literally, I went in there and I knew exactly what I was buying. I went straight to the things you'll see in the hall. Bought one for my mum, bought a couple for me. Went straight to the pen section. Bish bash bosh, picked up that. There's one thing that I regretted not picking up. And I'm not gonna, there isn't a Range very near to us. It's a, you know, few miles away. So I probably won't be getting them, but I should have got them, really. But I didn't. But it doesn't matter, I've got plenty of other stuff. And my husband waited outside and I was like, in, it's like Superwoman, boof, straight to the things that I wanted. Out. Now, I said to my husband, oh, I'm going to do a bit of video footage while I'm in there. I'm going to do a come shop with me in the Range. But I was just like so quick in there, I was like, didn't even think about getting my camera out until the last minute. And then I ended up just doing a bit of panning down the aisles. So I'll probably just include that in my other, one of my other videos. I'm going over these orange bits again because they're a bit light, and as they're drying you can see the dot. Starting to look alright there though. Starting to look more like it should do if we knew what it should do. So yeah, do expect another haul from me. And also, I was really naughty as well while I was on holiday. You know the Marco pencils? No, not Marco. I can't remember what they're called. They went down to a really cheap price, and they had 20% or 10% off. I was like, no. And it was like, I kept looking at them thinking they're going to go up. And then it's like on the Sunday, it was the last day of the cheap price, or the last day of the extra voucher thing. So I ordered them. I ordered them for delivery while I was on holiday. And you can do this thing where you can choose to have them delivered on your Amazon day. And our Amazon day was Friday, which was the day that we were driving back home. So I literally ordered them to be delivered on the day we got home. And I thought I was going to have a break. I thought I'd grab a holiday, and the Amazon man would have a break from me ordering stuff off of him for at least a week. But I still ordered stuff while I was on holiday. Because then I added two colouring books to my order as well. How naughty is that? That's really gone a bit. That paper's really gone a little bit. Breaking down a little bit there. Right, how much more of this orange I've got to do? I'm going to finish this orange and then I'm going to... Ooh! Really whacked the camera. Sorry, punched you right in the face. Yeah, because it's nearly 5:30 now, so that means I've been doing this for a while. And it's probably time for me to think about going downstairs and getting dinner started. There we are. It is Saturday, by the way. We only came home yesterday. And we are having pizza. You probably won't see this for a couple of days, though, because tomorrow I'm going to do some colouring and my holiday washing, and then it's back to work on Monday. So I won't be doing much. Is that the same dot? Yeah, it's lighter over here. This pen seems to be getting lighter. I'm not covering so well. Look at that, it's blobbing it on now. Yeah, this is definitely getting lighter. This was really red. Is that that bit there? Oh, is that supposed to be yellow? That's supposed to be yellow. Oh my word, that's supposed to be yellow, that bit going up there. What yellow was that? Do we remember? Perhaps I should leave the yellows out that I'm using. It was lemon yellow, wasn't it? Was it? I think so. Was it? Because that looks really light. Oh no, that was the quite cantaloupe, wasn't it? When there's a line break like that, you can't see. It's really difficult to see. Oh, I'm getting quite into it. Right, oops. Oh, that's not going to help with tips, is it? I just pushed the lid right on the tip. Right, yellow, yeah. Orange. Not too much left. Oh, that's the other thing I've stopped myself by, and I've been very good, very, very good, is that I was watching, who was I watching? Somebody, might have been Danny Buttons again actually, she was using watercolour. She was using watercolour in a really non-traditional watercolour way, you know, she wasn't, she was just using it as colour, rather than, you know, worrying about the translucency and spraying the palettes and all this kind of stuff. And it looked so nice, I was thinking, yeah, fancy doing some watercolour. Going to buy myself a watercolour palette. And then I remembered, no, I had to talk myself out of it. Because I have loads of watercolour medium in my art cupboard. So that is one, where am I? That is one thing that I'm going to do next week is I'm going to shop my art cupboard. I'm going to pull everything. Well, not everything. God, we'd be there forever. Someone suggested that I do a supplies thing video. Oh, my, you know, my colouring supplies. And I have so much stuff from over the years, from different hobbies, you know, from scrapbooking, from art journaling, from collage. I've got so many pens, so many things. It would take forever, but what I'm going to do is I am going to pull out everything out of the art cupboard and sort it out into like wet media and dry media, and then I'm going to shop my art cupboard and colour with what I've got, because I really am going to have to take the foot off the pedal on buying stuff, because not because any, you know, financial reason, I'm not going to go back broke if I carry on buying stuff, it's just that I've got to use what I've got. You know, it's a thing, isn't it? Jesus. Terrible. Over the line there. Just got to use what I've got. You're so zoomed in, you can see the dots. That dot on that orange there. That yellowy orange. That wasn't the best colour match, to be honest. Oh, look, I've gone over that line again. That line really doesn't want to be that colour. Oh, can you imagine watercolour? I remember when I was young, my aunt, I was about 8 years old, and she bought me a paint by numbers set that had oil paints. not even acrylics, oil paints, and it was a kingfisher. And the parts of the thing were this big. And I set that painting set up and I finished that kingfisher. Now that is a trait that is still with me today. I don't have any WIPs, any works in progresses. I start a picture, I have to finish it. And sometimes I do a mandala where I just test some pens out, and then I have to go back and finish that mandala. Even if it was just for testing pens. Like, these are all the same colour, yeah? And it, I just will not start having to finish all the food on your plate. Can't start another colour in until one is finished. And I did a lot of finishing little bits of colouring on holiday. I really should do a video of all the colouring that I did on holiday. I didn't do loads. I did about 10 pages, I think. I've forgotten where I am now. There. And the paper's really struggling a little bit now. Where was I? Actually, I might leave it because I'm getting a bit over the lines a little bit. Let's zoom out. Oh, that's in. Oh, I can't zoom you out. I have to pull you up. There you go. Oh, terrible light because of the overhead being on. That's where we are. It's been not too bad, is it? Should we see what it's supposed to look like, or should we wait for the surprise? It's not supposed to look like that, is it? Yeah, it is. Wow. My yellow is definitely not quite the same as that. Maybe they should be a bit more blended. Though he has got very distinct strokes. He doesn't use blended paint at all. But that yellow of them bits there is nothing like them dots that they put on there. Because my pen matches that dot almost exactly. And there it's like brown. Oh well, we'll see what it's like when we're finished. So, yeah, thanks very much for... If you're still here watching this colour and chat, well done. And I'll see you in part two when we get to finish it. Or maybe gets further into it.
Now I understand what you tried to say to me, how you suffered for your sanity, how you tried to set them free. They would not listen, they did not know how. Perhaps they'll listen now.